Hello people, welcome to this video guide about how to use Corel PaintShop Pro X8 with few and quick steps. If you find mistakes, correct us through comments. PaintShop is a software used to organize and edit photos in the best and easiest way. It is composed by three main different workspaces, all listed on top. Manage is used to collect and organize your photos. Adjust is used to correct and improve your photos. Edit is used to modify your photos instead. Each of these workspaces are supported by windows and palettes. In case you close one, you can open it again, going to View and then to Palettes. If you need room, you can collapse these windows by clicking on the Drawing Pin button. In this way, the palette will show up completely when you hover on its title. Let's see the Manage workspace. On the left, in the navigation panel, you can browse your pictures from your computer folders by going to Computer or from your collections, which are groups of photos made according to the tags, places, ratings, and so on. PaintShop is able to open and read images and videos, so just those will be shown in the center. On the right, the info palette lists all properties of the selected photo, like name, size, date, and stars. To check the photo better, just have a look at the preview palette instead. You can check better all the photos using the zoom bar at the bottom or your mouse wheel. Plus, you can use the rotate buttons to rotate fast a selected photo by 90 degrees. You can also check all in a full screen mode. Just double click on a picture. Use the arrows at the bottom to browse and zoom in out using the bar. Use Escape key or the cross to exit. Let's see the Adjust workspace. This is used to adjust photos without editing their content. Select the photo to adjust from the organizer at the bottom. To check your photo carefully, hover it and use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out. And, with the pen tool in the top right corner, check each part better. First step to do while adjusting photos is to rotate and crop the image. In the top left corner, you can rotate the photo by 90 degrees, left or right. And, to crop the image, just enable the crop tool, the first button from the left in the Adjust palette. This is used to remove unwanted parts from the photo. On the photo, you will see a grid that represents what you will save. You can resize it by dragging its nodes, move it by dragging from inside, and rotate by dragging from the central square. Select Freeform if you don't want to save the picture aspect ratio. Click on Apply when the grid is OK. Then, you may need to adjust lightness and colors of the photo. You can use Smart Photo Fix for this. Using also highlights and shadows to correct lighter and the darker sides of the photo. All you need to do is to check the photo in preview while you edit its properties through the bars. You can set the correct value typing inside or dragging the point inside the bar. To be precise, use the arrows next to the number. Remember that you can undo any mistaken step using Ctrl and Z. You can undo and redo actions using the two blue arrows on top of the image in preview. You can compare the actual photo with the original one using Show Original more below, or remove any modification on the picture using Revert. If the Smart Fix is not enough, you can use the other options inside the Adjust palette. Adjust Brightness and Contrast through Brightness and Contrast. While you can fully adjust colors using White Balance and Vibrancy. Last step is to remove noise and blurriness from the photo. You can use Fill Light and Clarity, High Pass Sharpen, and Digital Noise Removal. Use Local Tone Mapping to add some emboss effect. An advanced instrument to check all colors inside your picture is the histogram, on top of the Adjust palette. This represents the presence and intensity of the four main colors: red, green, blue, and white. In short, the more a color is on the right, the more it is light, and the more a color reaches its peak, the more are the photopixels that have such color. Below the histogram, you have some other advanced tools. The Straighten tool is used to align your photo more precisely. The Red Eye tool removes red eyes from people inside the picture. Just click on them and set the pupil radius on the left. The Makeover tool is used to improve people's faces inside the photo. Use the Blemish Fixer tool to remove the skin imperfections. The tool Brush 1 to make teeth whiter. The Eyedrop 1 to whiten eyes. The Suntan tool to color skin. And the Finify tool to reduce volume. Use always Ctrl and Z to undo if you need. Then there is the Clone Brush tool, very useful to edit your photo in order to cover parts you don't like. In short, this tool pastes parts of the photo on other parts of it. Enable the tool. If you right-click on the photo, you will fix a cross that indicates where you will copy from when you brush. Then, after setting all options from the left, click and drag on the picture. Even more, you can use effect templates on the extreme right on the picture through the Instant Effects palette. Click on the different templates to check them above and double-click to apply one. Use Ctrl and Z if you want to undo. The third workspace is the Edit one. This is more advanced and professional respect to the Adjust workspace. With this, you have tools to fully edit your photo in the way you like most. On the extreme left, you have all the list of tools PaintShop offers, including the ones seen in the Adjust workspace. Some of these buttons include multiple tools. Just click on the small white arrow in a corner to show them all. There are the selection tools, all grouped inside the third button, used to select the parts of the picture to be affected by your modifications. Then, the tools found in the Adjust workspace, from the Crop tool to the Clone Brush tool. Then, there are the tools to modify your photo, like the Paint Brush tool, the Light and Darken tool and its tools, or the Picture Tube tool. If you need, choose any color from the Materials palette. You also have other general important tools. For example, the Text tool is used to add text on your picture, the Pen tool to draw vector shapes, the eraser tool to remove pixels from your picture. If you want to learn more about the Edit Workspace, check out our video in this guide. Thanks a lot for watching!